Hey guys, so about a week or 2 weeks ago, not quite sure exactly when, but I recorded and uploaded the video in which I talked about heaven and hell. And I asked some questions about it, and then I made another video and I was just like, here's some more thoughts to consider about heaven and hell. And it was really just because I was having this back and forth email conversation with a Christian YouTube user. And so I just realized that after I made that video, a couple of days later, I got a private message, but this time from a Muslim YouTube user. And that reply was really kind of thought-provoking in a way to me, not because I agree with the Muslim guy's position, but simply because almost most of my questions around heaven and hell have really been centered, you know, it has a very Christian bias to it. You know, those are questions that Christians would find difficult to answer, but not necessarily a Muslim. It's just kind of like, that's when it struck me, like, oh wow, I had a cultural bias there, like a religious bias there, that, like, you know, it's because that's my background. You know, I'm a Protestant atheist. Before I was an atheist, before I became a humanist, I was a Protestant Christian, my denomination being Assembly of God. That's my dad's denomination. Now, many people, like, it kind of always strikes me as odd that many people, and it strikes me even more as odd if that any person is American. So it's really odd to me that Americans would not know what Assembly of God is as a denomination. Why does it strike me odd? Well, only because it's the second largest denomination in America, right? The largest denomination, the most popular, the denomination that has the most adherents or the most people who follow the denomination is, of course, Southern Baptist. And there's no problem at all. Like, you tell people, like, you're a Baptist, or I know a Baptist. Most people know or have an idea of what a Baptist denomination is like. But, like, I mentioned that when I used to be a Christian, you know, yeah, my denomination is Assembly of God. Get a lot of puzzled look from people, like, oh, what kind of denomination is that? Is that Pentecostal? Is that what? Like, that was just weird to me. It's the second largest denomination in America, and most Americans don't seem to know what it is. Just really weird. But it's bigger than, for example, Lutheran. It's bigger than, you know, all those others. It's bigger than Presbyterian. Bigger than something that starts with letter W. Can't remember what. Wesleyan, Methodist. It's second largest denomination in America, and apparently people don't know it. It has a nickname. It's either Assembly of God. It also has a nickname, Full Gospel. But Full Gospel is more of an international use, like in South Korea, in Singapore, stuff like that. Other countries more often use the moniker Full Gospel. But in America, they generally use Assembly of God, not to be confused with Church of Christ, which is also another Pentecostal denomination. Anyway, that's where my bias is. You know, my bias is that I'm a Protestant atheist. I was a Protestant Christian before I abandoned that and became an atheist. So, I that was interesting that, like, I got that response. I'm just like, you know what? Yeah, the heaven and hell questions. Maybe it's deeply troubling for a Christian. Deeply troubling for me enough that I had to, that was the beginning point. It's when I started asking about heaven and hell that I was just like, my religion doesn't really make any sense. Because I was so driven, actually. Also good background to know is that, you know, when I was a Christian, my ultimate goal, my career goal, was to become a pastor myself or become a missionary, because if people do end up in hell for not knowing Jesus Christ, then that's gotta be the most important thing to tell to people. I didn't want anyone to end up in hell for eternity. Like, that's such a crazy concept to consider, that a person would be suffering in pain for eternity. And when I was a Christian, I still have this belief that no one should go through that. No one should have that kind of torture. you know, I wouldn't wish that on my most hated people. And honestly, there's not really that many people I hate that I know. I can kind of picture a villain and hate that person. I don't know. The image of Hitler, you know, I guess because I've been taught that Hitler is such an evil person, I guess that person, I'll be like, yeah, that person is awful and deserves the worst kind of punishment and all that. But whatever. But I look at the world around me. There's no one I know that deserves to be suffered in hell for eternity. And the message of Christianity is that God has given this gift, a salvation out of hell. And that's Jesus Christ. You believe in Jesus Christ, you don't get to go to hell. So that's why, like, as a Christian, I was so focused on that. I was so driven by that need to make sure that people don't end up in hell. So I have to let them know about Jesus as much as possible. That's why I want to be a missionary. That's why I have to be a pastor. Because if eternity in hell or this finite life, what is more important? When I was a Christian, it was the life, the afterlife question. That was the most important thing. That was the most driven thing. But then I start thinking about it a lot more, and it doesn't make sense. How is it fair that a person can be judged for the finite time they have on earth, for the finite things that they committed, that they are sent and sentenced for an infinite amount of time? Doesn't make any sense whatsoever. Anyway, let's kind of just talk about this Muslim reply that I got. I thought it was really interesting. Of course, fundamentally, overall, ultimately, I disagree with a lot of the... Well, it's not that I disagree. It's just that I think this is not a satisfactory answer that the Muslim person gave. And so, my computer is loading, but I'll load it up. Basically, if I have to sum up his response, and like I said, when you try to answer the question about trying to justify the concept of heaven and hell, I ultimately think that the only possible answer you can really give is that, well, that's just... There's two ways that people can answer, and that's really it. Two ways. First one, God works in mysterious ways. We can't understand God. This is how just God does it. Second question, it's kind of related. That's how God is. This is how God did it. That's it. That's kind of the answer that I think this Muslim person gave to me. So where is that? I think this is it. No. Where? Gosh. Okay, sorry about this. I should have prepared more before recording. Huh. That's probably how all my videos should be. Oh, here it is. So this is from a YouTube user. I'll read some sections of his message to me. He says this. In Islam, we believe of the oneness of God, and to him is the eternal refuge, and he neither begets nor is born, nor is there to him any equivalent. So he is not a man like us, and Jesus was a great prophet of God. We follow him and love him, but he is not a God. Okay, so that's definitely one tenet of Islam. I agree. I took a brief course, college course in Islam, which is a very crude understanding of Islam. So, you know, I'm not an expert in Islam as I would be. I'm much more knowledgeable about Christianity than Islam. But from what I know, this definitely is concordance with what I know about Islam as well. Anyway, continuing on, he also says, and as I know in Islam, we cannot say there is someone guaranteed to enter heaven or hell, except the people that God revealed to his prophet. That is another story you want me to explain. Because we don't know what people do in their secret, only God knows, and we leave it to God to judge them in the day of judgment. And I hope we enter in heaven by the mercy of God, so it is not our matter. So, like I said, there's two ways of answering this question. Already you can see how he answered this question of heaven and hell. It's not our problem. It's not up to us. Because we human beings, we don't know the nature of God. God is secret. Only God knows. This is his response. Is it satisfactory? Not really. Because the problem with that is we're still at the mercy, at the whim of this being that we can't even see, that we don't even know exists or not. And it's up to us. And I really like this statement here, because this really is the centerpiece of it all. This is what he says here, and I'll repeat. I hope we enter heaven by the mercy of God. I hope we enter. So it's not revealed to us. Well, in Islam, it's revealed to them through the prophets who, what kind of people are to enter heaven and what kind of people are not to enter hell. But it's ultimately not up to us. It's God who decides, right? So when we have this religious faith, we have this devotion to God. We believe God to be all-loving, all-merciful, and all-just, right? We believe that because it's God, right? God is the ultimate being there is. He has to be this way. He has to make it so that when people die and that people, that person did horrible things in his life, well, God will send him to hell. And that people did awesome things in life, God will send him to heaven. Because God is a better judge than any human judge. That's kind of the religious mindset behind that. The problem is, how can you be so sure that that's the kind of God that this God is? How do you know? How do you know that this God is not an asshole? Remember, the key word is, I hope we enter heaven. I hope God has mercy on us. I hope God knows what he's doing. Right? So ultimately, the answer still is this unsatisfactory answer of, God knows, we don't know, God decides, and what God decides is the best. Now, here's the problematic thing about God's deciding, and also, like, he kind of tried to respond about this Muslim guy, tried to answer about my questions about, what about animals? You know, do they go to heaven and hell? And so his answer was like, about the animals and other creatures, same thing. God will judge them in the day of judgment. On what basis? You're right. How are they judged different? Like, what are they judged about? What is it about animals that can send them to hell? What is it about animals that can send them to heaven? Does any animal that you see living on this planet deserve to be burned in hell for eternity? And what is heaven like? What is the Muslim world of heaven like? Is that where, like, I don't know, this is my crude understanding of heaven, of Islam. Like, is that where you have, like, 70 virgins to have sex with, and women can have the perfect husband or something like that? What is heaven? What is this concept of heaven? And how can you do that for eternity, for forever? Now, keep in mind, this time frame is really important. When we're thinking about heaven and hell, it's forever. It's an infinite amount of time, which our brain, I don't think any of us can really comprehend. Life feels like such a short thing and such a long thing when it lasts 100 years, 120 years. But forever, dude. Forever. That's an insane amount of time. Of course, I actually, in regards to kind of asking a Muslim question about heaven and hell, well, actually, it can be with a Christian person too. I haven't really delved much, even, I could even delve deeper into this concept of heaven and hell that just makes things so convoluted and confusing when we try to answer it religiously. Doesn't make sense. The concept of heaven and hell doesn't make sense at all, no matter what religion you are. Well, also, think about if you are, this is a loaded topic, but I'll just kind of bring it up, abortion, right? Some of you guys think that aborted fetus is a person that just was murdered or dead or died, you know? Embryo is a person, is a human being. Well, does that embryo, if aborted, does it go to heaven or hell? If it does, why or why not? How can you justify an embryo going to heaven when an awesome person such as myself will probably end up in hell because I am not a Muslim, I am not a Christian, I am not any religion? So, according to almost all religions, I'm going to end up in hell. You'll probably have a friend who's going to end up in hell according to your religion. How is that just when an embryo who hasn't really done anything in his or her life can end up in heaven, right? What about a baby that dies due to a genetic disorder that really hasn't had a chance to really do anything in life? Where does that thing go, or that baby go? Sorry to refer to as a thing, I know as a person. So that was probably offensive. But, you know, there's all these other things to consider. There's all kinds of different kinds of life that people lead. How does God determine who goes to hell, who goes to heaven? Is there an intermediate place, like purgatory, as Catholicism would have you? Again, the question really is pretty simple, but it gets really deep when you start trying to answer this question in a satisfactory manner. And there really is no satisfactory manner to answer this other than this big notion of God knows what he's doing, and so we need to trust in God to make the right decisions for us. That's really all it is, this really crazy sense of dependence on a being that we don't even know exists, right? That we can't be sure exists. We have faith. We can have faith, but you don't know. We have no evidence of such a being existing. You only hope that he exists because, and also I just want to make one last quote about something he said here. So this is what the Muslim person said. When we die, about when we die, we just return to nothingness. Well, if that is the case, then everyone will do whatever they want and go with it if he didn't get caught. And that is not justice. As we know as fact that God is justice and that one of his names, and God could give a person some time, but he will never forget and will judge everyone according to what they did. So there's a idea here. There's a kind of the fundamental belief here in this Muslim person and many other religious people that if there is no concept of hell, there is no justice. There's no concept of hell, then people are gonna do whatever they want. Oh my gosh, I have no fear of hell, so I'm just gonna start raping and murdering people. That's the logic. Think about that for a sec. Really? Really? So if we have no hell, no heaven, there's no morality? If we have no heaven, no hell, then there is no justice of any kind? What is better, no justice or a perverted justice? That is a question you start have to ask yourself, because heaven and hell, if we really start thinking about what kind of concept they are, it's perverted justice. It's not fair. It's cruel justice. It's the cruel and unusual punishment in the worst sense of the phrase. Because no one... Okay, so this is my conclusion, but the question is, does anyone deserve a state of just total bliss for an infinite amount of time? So that's heaven. Does anyone deserve just constant and endless pain and suffering and torment for an infinite amount of time? Does anyone deserve that? Is there anyone on this planet who ever lived that actually deserves that kind of cruel and unusual punishment? Is there anyone in the universe who actually deserves that kind of ridiculously cruel kind of, if you're considering that it's infinite, you know, amount of bliss? Cruel because you're kind of a slave to this omnipotent being that you can't see in this life. I don't know. The heaven doesn't sound so fun to me, but people think of heaven and it's like, oh, heaven, I want to go there when I die. But that's another topic altogether. It's just, this comment, this private message that I got from a YouTube user was really awesome because it made me realize that a lot of my questions about heaven and hell had a Christian bias to it. But now that I'm trying to make you to readdress this question, thinking more of a person like this YouTube user who is a Muslim, you might be a Hindu, you might be, Buddhist wouldn't apply because not really, they don't really believe in heaven and hell. But, you know, all these other religions that do believe in heaven and hell, it's important to consider the concept of heaven and hell, of suffering for an infinite amount of time, of being a slave to an invisible being for an infinite amount of time, or purgatory, being stuck between the two for an infinite amount of time, or indefinite amount of time, not infinite. Like, the concept of that, does anyone deserve that? How can that be made, how can that be justified? Other than by saying that it's God. God is who it is. This is how God does it. We just need to trust in him. Which to me is totally, totally not a satisfactory answer. That is not an answer that can convince an atheist. And I hope it's not an answer that convinces religious people. It's not enough. I don't think that's enough to have faith in the concept of heaven and hell.